Hello, my name is Alexander Barron, and today I will be talking to you guys about why Africa is so rich in resources, but yet their citizens are very poor. So Africa is responsible for giving the world some of its most popular and useful foodstuff. For example, did you know that African wood are among the finest of the world, such as ebony and mahogany? Also, Africa provides a lot of gold. It can be found in several African areas, such as Ghana, Zimbabwe, but the largest source of gold is in South Africa. Since 1886, South Africa has been the gold-producing mecca of the world. Today, South Africa gold mines supply about 25% of the world's yearly gold. Also, South Africa is one of the leading sources of diamonds. Zimbabwe, South Africa, Ghana, Madagascar, Malawi, and Nigeria are excellent sources where emeralds can be found. Also, Tanzania and Kenya are the source of rubies that are among the world's finest stones, and in many instances, sapphires also can be found. Since World War II, the United States has become increasingly dependent on important minerals, and many of these minerals come from Africa. But now I want to talk to you guys about the major reasons to why Africa is, in a sense, very poor. Not the country as a whole, but the people from Africa. So one of the main reasons is that even though they have a lot of resources, they don't know how to manage them properly. Many of these countries have enormous reserves of minerals. However, mineral extraction in Africa is riddled with bureaucracy, inefficiency, and lack of development. This means that countries all across Africa are not able to benefit to the extent that they should be. Also, there is a lot of corruption in Africa, which doesn't let the country progress. So, for example, Mexico, what happens? There are so many great inventions and people and things in Mexico, but they aren't being fully used to the max. And the same thing happens in Africa. The rich continue to get rich and the poor continue to get even poorer. Natural resources can bring a huge wealth to a country. However, in order to gain the most from raw materials, countries must be able to plan, coordinate, and control the process of extracting. Otherwise, they're just losing money, and that is what's happening all over Africa.